Well, I want to say hello to all of you, our Christian Harvest friends, and this is our March 2020 email newsletter, and I am emailing you and doing this, as you can tell, from a hotel room. I am currently in Nairobi, Kenya, and we are having an amazing time. I'm with Apostle Julius Subi and his wife Martha at the Exploit Worship Center, and I am doing, for the first time since they have established this apostolic center, for the first time I am doing a training for them that they've ever had in the prophetic, a school of the prophetic, having an amazing, wonderful, awesome time. And I just wanted to come on and speak to you from Kenya. Guys, what an amazing, amazing time we are having here. And what a great work that Apostle Julius Subi is doing here in this nation. They are involved in every sphere of influence here in the nation. And they are very involved governmentally. They are involved in business, in the marketplace. They are involved in the church. They are involved in family. They are involved in arts, entertainment, and media. Just amazing. And they're actually birthing a new vision called Revive Kenya. And they are going into villages. There, especially one region where there has been a lot of poverty, and they actually did a whole prayer assignment when I was here 7 years ago. Time flies so fast. 7 years ago, I taught on prayer, did some deliverance, but also prayer and spiritual warfare teaching. And Julius himself is a dynamic intercessor and does teaching and training in this. So they totally understand spiritual mapping. They understand spiritual warfare, cleansing the land. And so they did a whole assignment to cleanse the land. And up in this area of Kenya, I cannot say the name of the village, sorry guys, that was very poverty stricken. After they did this whole initiative, then oil and resources started bubbling up from that land, and they began to produce oil. The land began to produce oil, and they began to pump for that oil, and actually, and that oil would go across the nation. And so he was just sharing about that with us. And actually, he received the very first fruits of that oil, and he has a jar of that. And we were able to lay hands and pray over that oil for first fruits. And they're going in to even do some more prayer strategies next week. They sent some of their intercessors in 4 weeks ago, 10 of them, who have been prayer walking the streets of this village, who have been doing mapping, who have been doing research. Because even though the land has started to produce oil, there were still strongholds of ancestral worship that caused divide and confusion and chaos. So now they're going in to deal with the ancestral worship this next week. And I just love how they strategize, because the Lord has birthed in him Revive Kenya. So they send intercessors in who are there for 4 weeks. They prayer walk the cities, they spiritually map, and then a group of apostles and prophets, key leaders, go into the region after the research has been done and it's been saturated in prayer. And together, based off of what the intercessors know and the research they've done, then they go in together and they pray specifically for that village to break the strongholds. And they're doing this all throughout Kenya. I'm just saying, these people are our tribe. They are so amazing in what they are birthing in this season. And I just had to jump on and share this testimony in this newsletter and say, you know, now he's taking it up a next level, and he wants to raise up prophets. And he said they have had some spooky prophets here in Kenya. And so I am the first that he's had to come in to do a school of the prophets, having a phenomenal time. Something that so blessed me. There was a young man named Joseph, and he walked into Subi's office. They call him Apostle Subi. Some people call him Julius. I go back and forth from Julius to Subi. But came into his office, and he smiled, and he said, "Do you remember me from 7 years ago?" And I recognized his face, but it's been 7 years. He said, "I'm Joseph." He said, "You gave me an amazing word about going to college and going to a university, and that God was going to provide for me supernaturally, that not only could I go to university, but I could take care of my mother, who was in deep, deep poverty, and my family." and provide a way for my family. So after I gave that word and I left, they began to pray and steward that prophetic word. And friends, do you know what was so amazing? God provided for this poverty-stricken young man supernaturally to go to the university, get a degree, not only to get a degree, to be successful in business, so much so that he has now built a new home. He's been able to take his mother and his family out of poverty into blessing and prosperity. And not only that, that whole word began to come to pass. And then when he was speaking to me, and you can just see the favor of God on this young man, and I turned to him and I said, not only that, but what you are doing in the villages and how you are teaching them how to come out of poverty, you will be in government, and that he will sit in government, and he will be one to help unravel the corruption that is here governmentally in Kenya. The vice president is a Christian. His wife is a spirit-filled, on-fire believer and for the vice president, but there's some divide and corruption in the occult realm that is going on in this nation, and they are very in tune to it and what has caused it and what is going on. And so this young man, I continued to prophesy over him, and Julius and Martha began to smile because they had already begun talking to him about this. And Joseph, the Lord had been speaking to Joseph, and he came to Julius and said, I believe I'm supposed to run for parliament for my village, that I can then be effective and help in the government and bring righteousness into the government. So here is this young man, based on a prophetic word from 7 years ago that was received, that was stewarded, prayed into, whose life, whose family, whose village is radically changing based off of one prophetic word from the Lord that helped this young man, Joseph, understand his calling and his destiny. It is so amazing to me when I travel the nations of the world and I speak and prophesy as the Lord leads me to into these individuals' lives, and I return 2 years later, 3 years later, 4 years, 5, 6, 7 years later, and the first half of that word has totally been fulfilled. Now he's gotten the second word, and as I'm giving it, Joseph, and I said, your name is not Joseph by mistake. God has called you governmentally to help people prosper in the finance arena, and you will do it even in a corrupt government, and you will pull that scarlet thread, your righteous voice, and cause the corruption to begin to unravel. And this was already what the Lord was speaking to this young man, and this prophetic word was the confirmation. So he'll run for parliament, and guess what, friends? He'll win. And when we come back the next time, I will probably see this young man positioned governmentally and having key influence in parliament, representing his village that he has helped so much. Just some amazing stories like that. You know, when we've gone into Russia, I'll never forget when we were with Roman and our friend in Russia, and I turned to their worship leader and I said, the Lord says not only one CD, but multiple CDs. I came back a year and a half later, and she had already written enough songs and for two CDs. Not only had she written them, produced them, and had released them out to the church in Russia. And so I know God is a God of timing, but what is so amazing to me, when you come into nations that are desperate for a move of God and Christianity is really springing up and growing, they hear the word of the Lord and they begin to pray in, and they so steward those words and begin to step into them because they understand that the nation, their nations, their villages, their cities, the lost, that the kingdom of God is in need of them and their calling and their destiny. So I just had to jump on and to share this praise report. And I just want to encourage all of you in your walks that, you know, blow the dust off some of those words that have been spoken into your lives. Begin to steward them. You can't force the word, but pray into it. Steward the word. If it's the word of the Lord, agree with it. And begin to ask the Lord, Lord, what are the steps? Am I in a waiting season? Then I'm in a waiting season. Am I in a season to begin praying in agreement with this word? Sometimes we have to wage a good warfare. We have to wage a good warfare over the words. You know, one thing that has happened recently to me this year that the Lord has started doing in my prayer time, he has spoken specifically to me about doors that he literally to me, he said, Becca, this door needs to open for you. And I want you to be at this event. I want you to be invited to be a part of this group. And you need to begin to intercede in agreement with this that the door will open. At first, it took me back a little bit because as an intercessor, I so diligently want to pray for others and for nations and for regions. And I heard it in my prayer room, not closet room, and wrote it down. The next day I came in and the Lord started speaking it to me again. Pray in agreement that these doors will open. So I began to pray. And I did this for 2 months. And I went to Greg after 2 months. And I was so certain, especially concerning one of the doors, I said, listen, keep these dates on the calendar clear. If anyone asks for me on these dates, I said, I cannot say yes. I feel like the Lord has been speaking this to me, that I am to be at this location on these dates. And I've been interceding and praying in agreement that that door would open, in agreement with what the Lord has spoken to me. And I said, and I feel like he told me today in my prayer room that within the next 4 days, we will receive the invitation to this first gathering that the Lord is wanting. I feel like the Lord has been having me pray into. And it made me a little nervous. And Greg looked at me a little funny because he's so used to me praying for others in intercession. And there's nothing wrong with praying for ourselves. But I thought, wow, it's like the Lord was speaking to me so specifically. It's like I was almost prophesying, hearing the Lord, writing it down and praying it out loud to myself. And I was. And I was interceding in agreement with it. And I began to intercede and I began to say, Lord, I speak in agreement that this door will open. I say yes. Lord, if this is where you want me to be, I say yes, I will be there. And I speak and pray that this prophesy that this door will open. And Lord, I thank you ahead of time for the open door. And I carried this way for 2 months as the Lord led. Within 4 days, the first invitation has come. After that 2 month period, it came within 4 days after I told Greg that. And he said, wow. And so I'm fully believing that the other is about to open up as well. So I just want to encourage you. What is it that the Lord is saying or that he has spoken to you that some of you might say, I need to blow the dust off of this and just dialogue with the Lord. Ask him questions. Listen to his voice. And say, Lord, am I to intercede in this? Am I still in a season of waiting? Am I still in the season of you building character? But hearing him over that so you can agree with him in the season that he has you in concerning the things that he has spoken. So, Lord, I thank you for all of our partners of Christian Harvest. Lord, I thank you that you bless them. Lord, I thank you, Lord, that whatever those promises are, that even as I'm speaking, that you're nudging and saying, hey, what about this? That they will go back and blow the dust off of those words and they will just dialogue with you about it and hear what your heart is and begin to pray in agreement and say yes to those things that you are asking them to step into in this season. And Lord, we give you all the glory and honor and praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Until next time, guys, talk to you soon. Bye.